This bunch of bicycle riders call themselves the Camaradas, and their wacky bikes, they call them Lowriders. We're in Tucson, Arizona, a few days before Christmas. It's over 80 degrees outside. The Camaradas are a lowrider bicycle club, and Herman is its president. Shade Tree is the oldest member of the club, and also the only white American. The others are Mexican Americans. They prefer to call themselves Chicanos. In Tucson, as everywhere else on the American West Coast, lowriding is decidedly a Chicano affair. During the week, the people of Tucson stay among themselves. But on Saturday night, those from the south, north, east, and west like to mingle downtown. Marianne has been living between the United States and France for the past 10 years. Before meeting the Camaradas, she was drifting a bit in Tucson.
The idea is that, you know, the bikes bring you peace to the community. This is for you, Marianne. It's for Los Camaradas, and bikes, not bombs. Look, see, biking right up here.
Oh, man, they're all doing bicycles.
Bicycles, see, they're doing bicycles here.
Right.
Once again, after spending 6 months in Paris, I come back to the Camaradas. Herman doesn't even wonder anymore how come a French girl hangs out with the Chicanos. I'm a member of the club, that's all. I found a nickname for Tucson. AA Town. Alcoholics Anonymous. They come here en masse to find a cure for the little and great addictions of this century. Life in the fast lane, plastic money, and the information highway. This is the place where Paul McCartney hangs out dressed as a cowboy, the place where Courtney Love comes to dry out. Here, no one's in a hurry. There's nothing so urgent that one word can't handle. Mañana. Tomorrow.
Thank you.
Chicanos call this region Tierra Mexicana, Mexican land. Arizona was Aztlan, home to the Aztecs, long before the conquistadors crossed the Rio Grande in their search for the Seven Cities of Gold. The conquistadors left, missionaries stayed, and the trains brought hordes of whites from the East Coast. The old Tucson Pueblo doesn't amount to much anymore. As for Aztlan, only the dream remains. The newcomers and the Arizona elite have settled in the desert, out of reach of the voices rising from the South Tucson barrio.
Thanking the Lord for what he's given us. I give him my life and I give him my trust. I started to think there's somebody left out. At that moment, I started to doubt. Then as I ended up my prayer and said amen, I started to notice that I felt happy again. Because I know one day they'll be by beside me, together at last and forever free. Merry Christmas, homies.
Alright, did you write that?
Come on.
Alright, what's your name?
Jimmy Wildman.
Jimmy Wildman.
Yeah.
Alright, and that goes out to your brothers, right?
Frankie and Michael Wildman.
Alright.
Oakland County.
There's some dedicated listeners on Radio Chicana. They're right. Always writing to us.
You got that. Yeah. You know Michael Wildman, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, Frankie. Hey man, thanks a lot though, girls, and to everybody out there in lockdown, man. Our hearts are with you guys, alright?
So okay.
Stay strong and keep the raza strong.
Right,
thanks.
Thanks for calling in.
Bye.
Bye.
Royal.
Not right now.
Come on, put it right now. New flags, ideas, new flags, you know, like. We've been talking about in the meetings. So here's one idea. That's another idea, but that one looks like. I know
that's
what
I said.
That one.
This one will go on the cars.
On the cars.
On the cars.
Oh, now we're
talking. Now we're talking on cars.
The Camaradas Bike and Car Club.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Something for the kids to grow into, you know?
I actually like it, like the city of Tucson, so that way nobody will give us any problems.
Yeah.
Why do you expect trouble?
Fun.
Well, when you
like
have it
this
like
one.
This.
See how it has just the S and then Tucson, Arizona? Well, a lot of gangsters, a lot of gangsters that we were claiming the south side of Tucson. You know how the south side and the west side have gangs? Well, the west side and the south side don't get along.
The east side.
And the east side.
So when South Tucson's actually its own city for real.
See, like, we try to claim this is for the city of South Tucson. We're not trying to claim the south side. That's when we had it. So we went as, let's put city of South Tucson better. You know what I mean?
You mean nobody claims South Tucson? It's like, forget it.
No,
it's just...
For a gang, you know, for claiming the south side,
we're from South Tucson, which is its own city, really.
It took 3 years for the Tucson police to finally figure out that the Camaradas were not a gang. Herman's brother, Alex, tells Marianne that the Camaradas and half a dozen other clubs have finally managed to start the Tucson Lowrider Coalition, the first step in an impressive series of community projects.
Pretty amazing. This is a virgin again.
Mm-hmm.
Did you buy the Lowrider Bicycle magazine?
I haven't lately. They said one of the guys from here is on there.
So the club is actually something that's keeping you entertained.
A lot.
Quite busy.
Oh yeah.
It's a lot of responsibility.
Yeah, lots of responsibilities, but you know, it's good. Keeps us out of trouble. It's like when we came down here, we didn't know nobody, so I guess the clubs like actually got us to meet people and got us out here, you know, show people, hey man, you know, a lot of people from California ain't that bad, you know. Usually people they hear that you're from California, like, oh, you know, they're bad people. No, you know, you just gotta prove them wrong, and we did, hopefully. At least I think we did.
ask Herman what happened to the girls from the club. His wife Mary smiles back and says they've moved on into politics.
You're listening to Radio Chicana 91.3 FM, KXA. You give us a call, keep those calls coming in, 622-KXCI. We're going to go ahead and give you all of the Chicano haps happening this week. Erika, what's up? The Arte group?
Yep. How do you say it, Marisela?
Capulli Toltec.
Alright, that was on Wednesday from 7 to 9 at the El Pueblo Neighborhood Center.
7 to 9 o'clock. Also, don't forget the Tucson Chicano Coalition meets every Tuesday, 6 o'clock to 9 o'clock at the El Rio Neighborhood Center. And that's a part of the National Chicano Moratorium Committee. Also, Braza Unida Lil meets every Friday.
Every Friday, 7 o'clock.
Like Marianne, Shade Tree can't stay put. This time, she tracks him down 10 miles south of town. His new shop is stuck between the Indian reservation, the desert, and the Air Force missile base.
Mr. Cameraman.
Fine.
Okay. I like it out here. It's better than where I was at.
How was it like? How was it like?
What was it like? It was like living in the middle of the ghetto. That's what it is. It's a war zone. And they just happened to pick my block to
to fight it.
Yeah, that's where all the action is.
At Shades, everything's different and nothing is different. The same old bike junk pile, and Alex B still sweet-talking his lowrider back into shape.
All right.
We need to find something to sell here, besides bicycles. Diapers. Go in the diaper business.
Well, there's that many kids around here?
Yeah, there's quite a few kids.
How did you pick Tucson?
Oh, this is my old winter spot. And I ride the trains because of the weather and a lot of customers here. I'd paint signs all winter and save up a couple thousand dollars and go cruising all summer. Yeah. If this don't work out, I'll be doing it again. So I'm gonna take the Amtrak. First class.
Jojo and Mike Garcia, Alex B and his lowrider, Eloy, Slowpoke. Camaradas have remained loyal to Shade, despite the distance they now have to drive to find him.
Thank you. But I mean, see, the way it goes is if you join a gang, you know, you have a lot of friends. When I joined the Camaradas, they told me that that was the first rule, that you couldn't be in a gang. But I was out of gang before I got into Camaradas Club. So I didn't really care, you know, and now I have like probably a year and a half that I've been in the Camaradas Club. And I like it. And ever since every single member that goes in, you know, we tell them, if you want to be in the Camaradas Club, you can't be in the gang. Because we don't have we don't want to have problems like in shows.
In retrospect, thinking back about the fact that this documentary, that this process was not done in the correct way because we were not told. In our culture, we ask permission, we're respectful. You know, we come in, before we go into a house, we knock. You know, before we ask personal questions, we build trust. And as far as the desert, that's something that's personal to me. You know, I don't just share it with anybody. We're exploited.
Miguel Ortega. He was the first to tell me of Chicanismo in Aslan. He was the first to tell me about lowriders. He'd promised to show me the desert. Doesn't he know that I'm a Camaradas? What else does it take to get his attention?
Real death, real people. And it's not something for someone suddenly to have these fads, suddenly riding lowrider bikes, you know. Oh, check it out, we have a documentary in Tucson. Hey, look at all these lowrider bikes. Suddenly you have all kinds of lowrider bikes in France.
I have a lot of respect for Camaradas. I have a lot of respect for Camaradas. I have a lot of respect for bike clubs and car clubs. Just being a Chicano in a car club, you're political because of where you are and the oppression. See what I'm saying? Just like a prisoner, no matter what you do, if you're a Chicano, Mexicano prisoner in the system, you are a political prisoner. See what I'm saying? You're a political prisoner because you're in an occupied land. We don't want to be exploited. We are not just chili peppers hanging from adobe. We are not just lowrider bikes coming through. We're not just mariachi music. Okay, we're real people dying from real issues, real exploitation, and real genocide. What the government is doing to us here is genocide, nothing short of that.
Thank you.
Qu'est-ce qu'un Chicano? Un Américain qui se prend pour un Mexicain qui se prend pour un Américain. I remember Guillermo Gomez Peña's words. What's a Chicano? An American impersonating a Mexican impersonating an American. I found a name to define myself. Franchica, the French Chicana. But now I realize this new identity isn't the answer. I am obsolete, Franchica.
This is the commemoration of the arrival 150 years ago of a group of U.S. infantry soldiers who are comprised of volunteers from a Mormon community in Iowa. Tucson at the time was a Mexican garrison, Mexican government. It was during the Mexican-American War, so the two countries were at war at the time, and it could have been a very ugly situation. But through a lot of diplomacy on both parts, the soldiers were able to enter the Presidio.
Diplomacy, I agree. Yeah. So this is like the first American flag, basically, to be put in Tucson.
This is the first American flag that's flown over Tucson.
What kind of reaction do you expect from the Chicano community around here?
We've had that reaction.
Tell me about it. I'm curious.
Well, the first reaction was that they were honored that we were including a Hispanic. A Mexican,
one of those three guys out
Teodoro
there.
Ramirez, was a citizen of Tucson at the time, and they were honored that we were having him as part of the commemoration, but they had some justifiable concern that we hadn't intended, but they felt it was a slight.
Weren't you expecting that? Are you
serious? No, we had not expected it at all. They were concerned that the size of the Mexican figure, that the two Americans were turned away from him, directing the placement of the flag. Those kind of things were sliding
him. The Mexicans
were
already out of the way 115 years ago.
So they were concerned.
What do you think? So did you readjust your design according to that?
Yes, we've had the artist change. Certainly the purpose was to have a community unity.
You see, man.
Appreciate you being interested in all of us, in our culture. However, we're not quite clear why you have this interest and what you intend to do with it. These things, whether it's a lowrider culture or my poetry, or these are topics or issues that that we don't consider novelty. They're not avant-garde. This is our life. So what we're asking is for you to respect that, and literally we want some backup, which I mean by a contract, a signed contract. Frankly, we don't have time, in fact, the Tucson Chicano Coalition, to worry about French television. I'll be honest with you.
Our culture over here is despised by a great portion of the society, and it's very dear to us because assimilation tells us to dress a certain way, act a certain way, and do things a certain way. Mm-hmm. And our dress, our cars, our culture, our whole language, our whole attitude goes against that. And that's the resistance kept us, yeah. Barely, our heads above water for these, 504 years or so that we've been, oppressed. We're trying to reverse 500 years of colonization, which has really left us blown in our minds, not knowing who we are, and just without direction, without a destiny, we're lost, and we're trying to restore our ties to our past, and that's what we're what we're doing. We're,
as you know, like we're on our way to the church. We all recognize the importance of Our Lady of Guadalupe, who was our indigenous mother. We look to her, maybe not religious values.
Chicanos won't play along with her story. She finds herself drifting again in Tucson.
Besides, who belongs here? Shade caught in between hoarding bikes and hopping trains. The Chicanos caught in between an Aztec dream and the American ways. Or me, with my tongue caught in between a southwestern French accent and this southwestern twang.
Pretty much, there was a lot of time I would just say, what the hell am I doing there? Yeah. I remember a Camaradas meeting after I was so stressed out. I couldn't figure out what I was doing out there. All those faces that were looking at me and talking in Spanish and stuff.
I've said that a few times myself. What am I doing here?
What are you doing here? Yeah. What are you doing here?
Riding down the street on a lowrider bicycle.
Like you're the youngest
your old gray
chick
beard
in the
hanging.
Well, see, they don't care about your age. They like that.
Sure.
That's fine.
I think it's great.
There's a mix of ages. Mm-hmm.
What it is, you know, you sow little seeds, you know, in these guys. They don't even realize it until later on in life, you know. Certain event will come up in their life and it'll just click in their head and it might save them a lot of hardship, you know? Because most of these kids in the club don't have too much upbringing. They're kind of a wild bunch.
So you think this whole film is about bicycles?
I don't even think it's really about bicycles.
Tell you the truth, I haven't figured out the bike thing yet. Mm. I don't know why everybody is into it.
Well, you have to be into something, right? Mm. And bikes are cool. You can use them. You can ride them, you're cool. See, a lot of people want to go somewhere, but they can't figure out what direction to go in. You know, somebody has to point them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of the other way, you know. I have one direction, I get stuck in it.
I probably did it 100 times, you know, flipped a coin. Which way am I going to go? Heads this way, tails that way. That's when you have nowhere to go. When you want to go.
That's what matters, going. Yeah, it's about Tucson. It's about the train that goes through.
Wild West.
Yep.
The last end. Frontier where you can
it's kind of the wear, end of that.
You can still wear a gun on your hip.
Alla derecha.
Pasa hell, suéltelo. Suéltelo.
No se mueve.
Saque las llaves. El carro.
What's it? De rodillas.
Como no.
Está error start.
Está bien. Muy bien.
Muy bien, señor. Muy bien. Está bien. El próximo equipo.
Marianne's still looking for answers.
Wyoming.
While the Chicanos choose not to talk, the police really open up.
The purpose of this training is actually twofold. And the first and foremost important, of course, is the safety of the law enforcement officer that makes a stop. But in many instances, we found out that the reverse is true. For example, many of the migrant workers that come to the United States from Central and South America work in the fields and they need sharp instruments to cut, etc. And an example could be that a person gets out of a motor vehicle with a machete, and that person views a machete as nothing more than a tool of his trade. The problem is the law enforcement officer that is making the contact with this individual views this as a potential weapon. In many instances in the United States, an officer has had to use force where perhaps a word or two, like don't touch the item that could be a weapon or drop it or something like this, could have prevented someone from being shot.
¿Por qué quiero aprender español?
Es necesito por la comunicación.
¿De dónde estás? ¿De dónde usted?
Colorado.
¿Va a aprender más español?
Is Spanish there to silence the guns? Or on the contrary, are the guns there to silence Spanish?
No, not.
Am I pointing the camera the way these cops point their guns? Is my film closing the very doors it should have been opening?
Sí, yo continuará in Colorado. Mm-hmm. Estudiar español.
Mm-hmm.
Abre tus ojos, tu fe te ha salvado.
Wetback. Mojado in Spanish. A derogatory term used to designate the Mexicans who illegally crossed the Rio Grande to settle in the United States.
Alex and his dad hate this word.
¿Usted ha papeles en Los Angeles? ¿Papeles de trabajo?
Sí.
When he came to Los Angeles, he had papers.
Oh, cuando vino, no.
No?
No.
No.
No, no, no era legal.
76.
76.
Yes. Y ellos en 78. Ilegales también.
Es muy difícil de vivir en Los Ángeles sin papeles.
No, yo tenía papeles, pues, pero sí, como quiere decir. Pues toda la gente sabe que cuando viene uno mal, viene uno mal, ¿no? Pero tiene aquí uno contactos y esa cosa, y entonces arregla unas cosas que ellos venden y reciben un dinero para trabajar y todo eso. Pero en el 86 nos inmigramos, cuando hubo la cosa esa de la, ¿cómo se llama? La amnistía.
La amnistía.
86. Sí.
Pues, miré, ¿y tú, la familia?
Toda la familia, toda la familia.
¿En 86?
¿En 86? ¿En cuántos años vivieron en Los Ángeles antes? ¿10 años?
10 años, sin papeles.
Every time somebody says, you know, where'd you grow up, where were you from? I say Jalisco, and they're like, man, that's so pretty there. And it's a shame that I don't really know it, you know. A lot of people do, and I don't, you know, I'm from there, so I gotta go back and live there for a while. Go back to my roots, you know. Chicanos, Mexicanos, you know, that's always been the struggle, trying to get the Chicano and Mexicano together, you know. I'm Mexicano, I'm not Chicano, so I don't know, I'm not, and I'm not really struggling the same way that you could say they are, you know. I don't know, it's different. To me, I see it different, you know. Like, and it offends me a lot when I see, like, Chicanos calling Mexicanos, you know, wetbacks or, you know, stuff like that, you know. Because they are, you know, that's their brothers, and they're always fighting against them, and then they want to get together, you know. It's funny, you know.
Where is she like?
You want to see Snow White? Hey, Herman, you're going to become American?
Mm-mm. No, I don't want to.
I'm going to become American before you do. I'm starting the paperwork in January.
Okay.
Yeah, be quiet.
Yeah, I will. I guess. And Marie wants me to.
No, I'm not. It's up to you.
Lay down.
Well, like he says, he's a Mexicano and I'm a Chicana. And I'm, you know, pure Chicana and he's pure Mexicano. So it's like two different cultures right there. But, you know, I mean, we're all the same people. And I mean, we come from the same background, you know. It's just maybe because they were born in Mexico. So that's why they're called Mexicanos. And me for being born in America. That's probably why, you know, but, you know, like he says, we've been married already almost 5 years. And he says, you know, he feels like already a Chicano, not a Mexicano anymore, you know, I'm like, but then he changes back, well, I'm a Mexicano, you know, I'll always be a Mexicano. I'm like, okay, you know. I was thinking of coming to myself, bringing up a girls bike club, just pure Chicanas. And a park club. But see, I have some guys, I'm not gonna say who, but I'm gonna say guys think a Chicana can't do what a guy does. But that's wrong. A Chicana can.
Okay,
but anything, poetry, right, building a bike, art, you know, anything, they have to come up. They shouldn't hide it. Like me with my poems. I hide them. I shouldn't hide them. I should come out and do it.
That's what Leon was looking for.
Well, that's what I think. The girls, but I mean, I should too. Okay, so do you know who you are? Do you know who you are? Do you know what race you are? Well, I don't. When I was a little chavalita, I didn't know what Chicana was or what it meant. All I knew that I was a white from what my birth certificate says. I guess my parents didn't want me to know or they weren't down for the raza, who knows. But I'm learning now, as I hear Chicano history on TV or from Dada Chicana, I wish the word white could change on my certificate. But now when I have to put my race, I put Chicana. I write it with pride. So whoever doesn't know who they are, learn it. because I wouldn't want you to feel like you don't know who you are. I'll never forget who I am now, a Chicana.
Modern-day Chicanas use food processors for their masa, name children after themselves, drive their own lowriders, sing their own songs in memory of Selena, sport black facial hair instead of bleaching it, ask Mondo out on a date, drink tequila, and draw a crowd by playing the guitar. Don't mind a little sunshine, even though they'll get darker. Fondle keys to a new car instead of a rosary.
Where she said that the Mexican women are, Chicana women see the difference in generation.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
The Chicano women don't bleach their facial hair anymore because they didn't used to, well, you know, they didn't let us do that. But now she brought out a point that I can see that in our times we did everything to make ourselves look whiter.
Yeah.
But we don't need to do that. My mother used to tell me one time I came home and my best friend was as blonde and blue-eyed as she could be. And I went home and I told my mother, I said, how come my skin is so dark? And she said, you know what? She said, God loves us a lot. She said, so he gave us a little more color. And I believed that, and I thought it was wonderful. So I never felt that my skin was a problem. And even though it did give me a lot of problems later on, but anyway. Currently, across the country, there's an anti-immigrant sentiment, you know, that plagues this country. And there's this thing that is really disturbing to us, especially us activists, and you know, people like my mother and father, is this whole English-only thing that's occurring right now. What that is it's a law that would restrict the use of Spanish when dealing in government offices, on government documents. Spanish was not our people's real language. It was Nahuatl, you know, our Aztec, our indigenous peoples. We would love to have that language back, but Spanish will do, you know what I mean? I grew up a little bit wondering what was going to happen to us. But thank God that my father was a believer in education. He was a Mexican from Mexico City that came up here because he did not want to join the revolutionaries. He did not want to join the Mexican army. So he fled from Mexico. And I think it was like a seeking asylum, political asylum, because he didn't want to. And when he came into the United States and met my mother as an American girl, a Native American, they fell in love, and then they decided to follow the railroad, which a lot of Mexican people did. But we were raised Anglo, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, actually, I'm dressed like the viejita more than they are, you know, but and the all-black type thing. My mother likes to say that she's not the kind of Mexican woman that what, Mom?
Oh, one day I was getting ready to go to a meeting. And she was saying, where are you going to now, Mom? I said, well, I got to go to this meeting. She said, I don't know why you don't stay home like some of her friends that their mothers stay home. I thought, So I went back in and I put on a black dress. I got me a black shawl, got my rosary, my prayer book. And then I said, come here, Jessica. I said, is this the kind of mama you want? With what I wanted to impress her with, that we women are empowered too. Modern Chicanas, I'm not a modern Chicana, but that's okay. You can call me that if you want. We know that we have the power to talk, we have the power to do. If some things don't get done, it's because a woman wasn't behind it. Yeah, really? There you go. And I have learned that. I have learned to speak for myself. I have learned to educate myself. I have learned to help my children get educated, and we're doing what we're supposed to. And I no longer ask my sweet husband, can I go? Can I go? I go.
Marianne wanted to cross the border in her search for the roots of Chicanismo.
Two times around the plaza, and our Mexican escapade stalls right there. The Camaradas miss Tucson. They are not in their place. Here, they are simply Americans. The snake is biting its tail, and I don't know which way to turn to understand Chicanismo. Mexicans in the process of Chicanoization. Or were they Americans in the process of Mexicanization? Frenchies in the process of Chicanoization? Or Mexicans in the process of Mexicanization? ¿Quién sabes? I wanted the Chicano conviction for myself. They gave me their silence. I wanted for myself their points of reference, certitudes, their violence. They sent me back to my doubts. I believed that I could customize myself into a lowrider and become a Chicano. But through making this film, I realized I couldn't be a lowrider. Does that make me a Peugeot then? Since the Franchica model has not yet hit the assembly line. We've come full circle. I know at least one thing without any doubt. It takes a chrome fork on a bouncing spring, and you're cool. A Dayton wheel, two leather strings hanging from the handlebars, a pot of golden flake paint, and a banana seat. What really characterizes the true lowrider bike is the 2-inch maximum distance between the pedals and the ground.